εντάξει, σχολείς με τον κολοτέχνη σου, εσύ. Θα βγω να το πω. Αλλά μου σχέδιες προτρέτω, τον νου σου.
Ναι, ναι, ναι.
Τα έχω όλα στην κάμερα.
Ναι, ναι. bags, you give me a cloth, a piece of jewelry, anything you would like to give that someone else could use, and it's valuable to you. And you don't mind sharing a story that comes with it, why it's valuable, why you want to give that, and it's going to stay in your life with the other person forever, you won't take it back. So I'm going to begin with my possession here. It is an oyster card. So the story behind it is something, okay, it only has £9 in it, it's not quite expensive. But my story with it is very emotional, and I kept it for 10 years because it reminded me of the kindness of strangers. And when I look at it, I know that I'm never alone wherever I go. The day I got this card, I had money to eat or travel, I was left alone in London. And a homeless person actually gave me his oyster card. And he didn't ask anything in return. And it breaks my heart that I need to leave it here for someone else to take it.
Did I get it right? I put something there and I get it back again.
You can pay anything that you want from the voucher and you'll get your voucher back.
Okay, I can put this really beautiful t-shirt. I bought it in the Dolomites where I was hiking. And yeah.
We put there we don't get lost forever.
But you can take something else.
So?
You can take something else in its place.
I have a with some chocolate on it. I got it at the grocery store earlier, and I actually have an allergy to wheat, which is very strong. I was speaking German, so I needed to ask the worker at the store to read the label and make sure that there wasn't anything in it that could make me sick. I was very touched. It was very touching.
Shopping bag. I had it for 5 years, and a few months ago I made this one myself.
Hi. I'm sorry, can you give your feedback, please? Can you give us some feedback before you go? Is there somebody who can translate?
Important objects that they do not get back.
Okay.
about the borders and about politics. I don't know if this is possible.
Would you mind if we all move a bit closer to the object? And also, people can come on this side so that we can make a circle around them.
So actually, yeah. I have this Mensa card from Berlin here, where I spent my last 1.5 years, and I will leave the town soon. So maybe that's a good opportunity to give it to someone else.
I will take this opportunity to leave this. It's the first drawing I made in Kassel, and I will take this because I'm going to Berlin tomorrow.
So this is about cards and eating, so mine fits very good. I think it's a card with stamps. If you eat pizza in Hamburg, it's my favorite pizza store, you get a stamp for each pizza, and if you collect 8, then you get pizza free. I collect this not for me, because I like to I wanted to give, when I reached 2 cards, which means 2 pizza, I wanted to give it to somebody, like a birthday present or something like that, that somebody can go there with a friend and have a pizza. So I have to start on my, I have to start again now, but I think it's no problem for me to start again. But this is from Hannah. And if you don't mind, I would like to take this drawing, and if not, thank you.
Okay, so I have this card. This is my participant's card, because when I sat for exams in the National Theatrical Theatre School of Athens, yes, in which I failed, and then I went to another drama school, which is very good, so it doesn't matter, but I wrote this behind of this card a message which says, which is Samuel Beckett's, and it says, ever tried, ever failed, no matter, try again, fail better. So it's a good message.
Hi, here a recipe of a cake my husband made to me. And these are the ingredients. It's a kind of a shopping list, but it's a very good cake.
In the hospital habe ich zwei Klinik in Kassel and here is a bonus card for the cafeteria and if 10 coffees or other drinks the card is full, you can have one free.
It saved kind of half of my feet during this horrible cold summer in Germany. Maybe I won't need it anymore because my way to the car might be quite short. And
I take the recipe because I love cookies.
Thank you. Ich hätte hier noch eine Fahrkarte aus München, das sind noch zwei Streifen. Gut. Und ich habe noch eine Langstrecke für Berlin, das ist auch noch gut.
Can someone translate?
These are two tickets, one for Munich and the other one for Berlin. And to Berlin, it's a long distance ticket. And they are still valid. Yeah.
Again, they can it's always very good.
Actually, it's not to Berlin, but is it to Berlin? Nach Berlin?
In
Berlin.
In
Berlin.
Yeah,
Berlin.
Yeah.
In Berlin.
I'm thinking of that.
can yes. check.
Yeah, yeah. Oh.
There's already a lot of plastic in there. This is the key for the room in my hotel.
Smells very much. And we both have made very, very interesting and wonderful trips in Europe. This smell has been in Rome, in Florence, Cinque Terre, in Barcelona, which is Barcelona, America. But we had the Ramos and Epsilon to Zurich, but yesterday the people had tried. But in New York and Toronto, there are our thoughts everywhere, and other wonderful places, and I take it here, and I take the tickets from Munich, because I would like to come back to Munich.
I got a ring, and it shows a little frog holding a glass ball, and it's of a German fairy tale, Froschkönig. And I got it when I was like 17 years old, and it got lost in all my things. I didn't find it, and then I was cleaning up after 20 years or so, and I got it back. And I really love it, but I think it's of my younger days and I can give it away. So I leave the frog here and I take a smell.
So this is even fulfilled. It's the only thing I found in my pocket that I don't need. And I get healed if somebody needs some medicine, just take it.
I started smoking again a few weeks ago, and today I bought a package of cigarettes and this light. And as I met in the afternoon, I was looking for it very desperately. And 14 minutes ago, 15 minutes ago, I found it again, and now I feel free enough to go to sleep.
Good chance to go with that. Very good chance to go with that.
One day again.
I put it in the bag, and I would like to take the t-shirt.
So we have to take it up here again.
If you gave it the first time, then you
Sorry?
If you gave it some
first time, and you didn't take something, you can go ahead and take some. If you have already taken, you cannot take a second time.
Can you do it a second time?
So there is someone watching us and he wanted to contribute. So this is on his behalf.
Instruments.
Mm-hmm.
We, as I write it at the front,
maybe I'm like a violin, so this is more tune. No. So I offer you $20. Euros. You offered 15.
Can we do a bidding?
It's a beautiful, it's golden.
I don't think it's golden.
It's a beautiful gold-plated ring with a semi-precious white stone.
It's very weird to look at it. Actually, a frog holding a stone.
Wow.
Can I sit closer?
With a very interesting story of adulthood behind it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you don't know my story. It's for a present.
Okay.
As a present?
Yes.
To whom?
To all. Well, because it's a personal story. This
I exchanged the ring for the story.
Even if I don't like the story, but it needs to be personal.
It's a love story. It's a woman and I.
She likes frogs.
Oh, no.
You need to be a bit more personal than that.
Sorry?
You need to be a bit more personal than that.
It's a beautiful thing. It's magnificent and
what
looks good on me. So.
What? Okay. We are alone and it's only between you and me. You and me.
Mm-hmm.
And you and me.
Well.
And for all other visitors come tomorrow, up to the end of the world, maybe. It's in the internet.
Of course.
In the eternal net. The internet.
I can,
eternal.
Maybe if you want, I will not
okay.
Share your face.
This story is very simple. Okay, I fell in love into this, with this woman. Okay? I wrote in a letter about the frogs and bees. That would be my friend.
How come you wrote letters instead of emails or Skype? How come you wrote letters?
No, it's a message. It's technical. It's, yes, not really like letters.
Is it for a special occasion? It's your birthday or something?
Yes, a birthday.
How old is she?
42. Oh, she was going to be 42.
What's her name?
Her name? If I tell you her name, you can Google her.
I promise. That is
a queen name.
Okay. Would you be happy?
Just a queen name.
Sorry?
Just a queen name, maybe. Yes.
Yeah.
And her first name.
Yeah, and her first name. Tilly.
I remember myself.
Sorry?
Are you making this up? The story, is it true?
Yes, it's true.
Can you prove it to me somehow?
Come here. She's an actor, yes. Not really famous. Not really, but.
Is she Charlize Theron? I need to tell everybody. It's my obligation to tell
you. Yes, okay. So this is her number.
Mm-hmm.
No.
That's Donald Trump.
It's Donald Trump.
She doesn't like it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
you're safe.
She doesn't like it. I'll show you a picture, okay?
Yes, please.
Where's my photo? Sorry, you made it. No, that's my name.
That's
my
name.
So the first Donald Trump, and then it's not.
No, I don't want the doors, I wanted to see your face.
Okay. Thank you very much.
And so I can show her link. If this is will be
on YouTube.
On YouTube? Forever.
Forever. Everything on YouTube is forever.
Yes, it's one YouTube thing.
It's a YouTube channel.
Okay.
You can find today's session there. It's going to be uploaded tonight.
But it won't really lead.
No,
okay. Then I can get the link.
So I lost my item, and I'm going to get the pass to the museums in
Vienna.
It's in your name.
That's no problem.
It's no problem.
You won't check your passport.
Okay.
You're female.
But I am. So, you went there for vacation? Mm-hmm. You went there for vacation?
No, I stayed in Vienna, Austria. And I don't stay far away from Vienna. So, very often I go to Vienna.
See you bring us now in a meeting.
Yeah. Yeah. It's good to know.
It's good to know. So thank you for coming to the originator. So nobody is talking, so can I ask you about this picture and some questions?
Mm-hmm.
You were asking so much, I think I'd be free now. So you are new in Kassel?
Sorry?
You are new here in town in Kassel?
Yes, I've been here for a month now.
And where did you come from originally?
Athens.
Ah.
Athens.
And where is this?
If you go up to the cafeteria, there is a little park there,
And if you look down, there is a little stand for ice cream, and this is the picture.
And is this special location for you, or why did you choose this to draw it?
Well, it's hard to get used to the city because it's much smaller than the one I come from. And so I sat there one evening that I didn't feel very well, and I just drew this.
Everybody to leave something useful, and she left a drawing because she chose to pick it up. So,
well, I did pick it up because we are at the documentary now. This is World Art, and I thought that was the next drawing. And what is your question about fairness? What do you?
Because it's a drawing. How useful can it be, I guess, given, let's say, your pizza stamps coupon?
Well, this is about comparing values of different kinds, I think. I don't know if it's really comparable. This is for me, it will be useful because I can have it at my place. And pizza is useful. Somebody's in Hamburg and it's a really good pizza store for pizza. I don't know if it's really comparable.
I guess to you, there is a way to use it.
Yes, of course. If I wouldn't like to use it, I wouldn't have chosen it.
You don't feel cheated in any way. A sock you can wear, a lighter you can use, a painting you can wash.
Yes.
It's your imagination that does the work.
I don't really understand.
No. Okay, that's okay. It's just a point of view.
May I ask you a question?
How
are you using the story which you exchanged for the ring?
How am I using?
The story you exchanged for the ring. Like, what was the value for you of getting the story?
There was a ring and a story to go with it.
It's going to be a best job.
So I did feel it was fair that she gave up actually a ring and a story to go with it. The value for everybody's different.
That was okay. And I think we...
That's good for you.
It was difficult to be that open as I was. For me, to put some pressure, some soft pressure. But it was the best to be opened up like that. Can show the video.
Yeah, well, when you leave this place, I want to believe that besides the experience, you have something physical.
Yes.
To look at.
That is a good experience, by the way, as well. Sometimes. Maybe that's the deepest sense behind the project. Mm-hmm. So, finding something human, humane, oneself. Open up the people with asking them to give something first, and then to take something second, and then we have this exchange. It's good. Better than an auction.
You were the only one who actually claimed what he wanted.
Yes.
So saw this deep need to get the subject. So I guess it took some courage to do that, even in an art room. Even in an art room, a place where we're protected, everything is acceptable.
So about today, one thing that came to my mind, because of the big silences we had, I thought that it was a bit difficult for us to communicate outside of what these items represented. I think no questions were asked outside this frame of this little game of exchange. And I found very interesting that question of value. How do you value something? Is it according to how useful it is, or how you define how useful something is anyway? And I would like to ask, I mean, we don't have so much time, but maybe it's something that we can have in our minds. I would like to ask if you think today we helped the collective subject to emerge. It is the last sentence of the score.
Can we answer?
If it's short, yes.
It's short? No. Because you talked a lot about fairness, and it's very unfair that you make the roles, but you also participate in the game. And so you have a position of power that's very strong. And so for me, my only, when I read this again, helped the collective subject to emerge, and I thought maybe we could make a formal union against you guys.
What kept you from doing this?
That also, I didn't want to be the individual narcissist, but it's a balance.
Forming a union is not individualistic in any way.
No, but I needed to take, I needed to start speaking up in the middle of everything, in a way that would have been very performative.
And also, you already took a t-shirt.
And I already have an orange t-shirt.
So you were beholden to them. You had already benefited from their rules. So
yes.
And
the only way you could have interactions that were beyond this is if you cuddled up to the master and, you know, told a very personal story to the person who was in charge of the game, and just kind of bowed in front of you. So I think it is very interesting that I felt that was very unfair in any way.
I thought that a collective subject did emerge because I was confused, or I wasn't sure. At a certain point, you named a rule of the game, which was that when someone had put in one thing, they could take one thing out, but maybe they couldn't take two things out, or maybe they couldn't give again, or there was some rule like this that was referred to, but it had not been established at the outset. But I wasn't sure whether you were giving it to us, or whether you had observed that as the way we were behaving and then codified it this way we were already behaving as a rule. And because I wasn't sure whether our behavior had been spontaneous and then gave rise to this rule, or whether this rule was being imposed on our behavior, because there was this way in which it wasn't clear whether this rule, it seemed as if we had all made this rule together. So there was some subject that preceded that and that created that.
In my opinion, I observed some kind of collectiveness in this experiment, but I definitely also observed individual calculation, which is kind of the total opposite for me in terms of emerging collectiveness. So I think, it was both. I observed that many people were thinking about giving away something of individual or personal value, but nobody some real, really, really important stuff. Maybe off course, but because I didn't do it also. But I think at the time when there were several items, some individual calculation started among this group, and I don't want to judge it negative, but I think it's really hard when you try to to get more collectiveness, to get rid of this individual maximizing. I gave something away and I get a better deal. So the big word, everybody, hopefully not everybody would try to get a better deal, but yeah, I think it was good.
I observed that there were two or three objects given a real value. The ring, the beautiful leather pouch, and possibly even the Vienna Museum pass, and they were all given by women.